So, what's up guys, how to do a compilation program with STV. We'll continue with our series. Now, in this class, we're going to answer the question, what is Kotlin? Okay, so we're going to explore Kotlin, a programming language that is really becoming quite popular. Okay, so as we explained right here, we're also going to be writing some notes. Okay, so that I can give you guys something to. We can follow step by step, okay, instead of me just talking. So yeah, of course, we're going to be moving step by step, covering both theory and of course practical examples. Okay, so some classes will be more theoretical, where we're explaining, like an example is this particular class right here, and then also in other classes also we'll also be looking at more examples, okay, practical. So, of course, what is Kotlin? Of course, Kotlin is actually a programming language that was created by Jetbrains, okay? Now, Jetbrains is a company that is renowned worldwide for the creation of IDEs. So, we can come right here and say Kotlin is a statically typed programming language that was created by Jetbrains. Okay, so you may already have heard about this Jetbrains. They normally produce IDEs, for example IntelliJ IDEA, okay, Android Studio, which they've partnered with Google, and also PHP Storm, WebStorm. Okay, I personally use some of their IDEs. So Kotlin writer is a statically typed programming language. So as a language, it's actually targeted to run on the JVM. Okay, so it targets JVM. Okay, that's of course what it runs on. JVM, Java Virtual Machine. It targets JVM, Java Virtual Machine. Okay, so Java Virtual Machine. So actually Kotlin, it does address a majority of the redundancies in Java programming language. Okay, and it has also added features that make application development in Kotlin much faster and a lot easier and also more fun than say in Java. Okay, so some of the advantages right here. First, we say that Kotlin is actually easier. Okay, so let's come list some of the advantages that you can get from Kotlin. So come right here, advantages of Kotlin. Okay, so the first one is that Kotlin is actually much easier to learn than Java. Okay, so that's our first advantage. We're going to see that one, especially when looking at examples. Then Kotlin is also more compact. Okay, so it's a much more compact. Then the third advantage is that Kotlin does support, does support both OOP, object oriented programming, as well as functional programming. Okay, so you can actually choose the type of the paradigm that you want to use as per your preferences. So both of them are fully supported. Okay, Java is mostly an object-oriented programming language, but of course which has some functional features. Now Kotlin can actually support both fully, okay, both object-oriented as well as functional programming. Okay, so object-oriented as well as functional programming, both of them are supported. Now the fourth advantage that you can assign to Kotlin actually has a reduced, it excels in reduced compile time. Okay, it has a smaller compile time than Java. Okay, so compile time than Java, which is quite an achievement, because as you know, Java as a programming language has existed for decades. Okay, almost 3 decades now, while Kotlin has only been around for around 5 or 6 years. Okay, so Kotlin has a smaller compile time than Java. Okay, in fact, is also not just Java, but also most languages. Okay, and also many languages, statically typed languages. So that's also an advantage of Kotlin. Then of course Kotlin, another advantage is that Kotlin is actually interoperable with Java, so you can interoperate it with Java. So if you already have existing Java code, you can actually mix them, of course, with Kotlin. Okay, in fact, you can even compile your Java code to Kotlin, and of course Kotlin code to Java, so it's interoperable with Java. So yeah, now also because Kotlin does run in, of course, the JVM, of course it's actually cross platform. Okay, so Kotlin is cross platform, so meaning that you can actually run it in different operating systems. Okay, as long as the JVM, those particular operating systems are supported by the JVM. So also Kotlin can also be compiled to JavaScript, okay, which is quite a unique feature. Kotlin can be compiled to JavaScript. Okay, so if you don't like JavaScript, you can actually write your code in Kotlin and then compile it to JavaScript. Okay, now another advantage is that Kotlin is statically typed languages. Kotlin is a statically typed programming language, so this actually provides with better IDE support. Okay, for example, we can take advantage of IntelliSense, and also given that it's also statically typed, of course it's also going to be much much faster than say dynamically typed languages. Okay, it also, this static typing also allows us to write more type safe code. Okay, so it's a statically typed language. We've also said that it's cross platform. Okay, so these are some of the advantages. So yeah, of course, first to say this easier, okay, to learn than Java. Okay, that's of course an advantage because Java is actually a beast of a language. Now, it's statically typed, it's a statically typed programming language. Kotlin is also open source, so Kotlin is open source. Okay, so open source right there. Okay, in fact, it's distributed under Apache license. It's, let's note that one, it's for those people who care much about licensing. So it's distributed under the Apache 2 Apache license version 2.0. okay, so Apache license 2.0. okay, yeah. Now of course, yeah, the Kotlin compiler. Now if you say Kotlin is open source, all we mean is that actually the Kotlin compiler, okay, that is the compiler used to compile Kotlin code into bytecode, the IntelliJ IDEA plugin, okay, that you use, also the enhancements that have been made to basic Java libraries, as well as the build tools, all of these are open source. Okay, now we've also said that Kotlin is interoperable with Java. Okay, it's interoperable with Java and Android. In fact, you can use Kotlin to create Android, and we're going to have classes where we're going to do that one. Okay, a lot of examples. So it's actually 100% interoperable. Maybe it's important to insist of this 100% interoperability, okay, with Java. So yeah, the Android team actually recently also did announce that Kotlin is actually a first class language. Okay, it's a first class language that we can use for developing Android apps. Okay, so in addition to that, of course, we've also said that Kotlin allows you to compile some Kotlin projects to JavaScript modules. So yeah, that is it. Kotlin, we've also said, it's much more compact, not only compact, but is also concise. Okay, much more compact, concise, and expressive. Okay, so yeah, that's, these are much better adjectives to describe Kotlin. Okay, so normally, by according to rough estimations, of course, using Kotlin can allow you to cut off the length of code by approximately 40%. So you can imagine that's a very huge number. Okay, cutting down the length of code, the LOC length of code that you write to by approximately 40%. Okay, so if we say that it's of course expressive, all we mean is that Kotlin code is much easier for both humans as well as compilers to understand. Okay, so Kotlin is also easy to learn, we've also said that, and of course it's a language that has been influenced by several programming languages like the C#, Scala, JavaScript, and even Java. Okay, so it's easy, especially if you already know any of those particular languages. Okay, and especially it's easier, even easier, if you know Java. So Kotlin of course is also tool friendly. Okay, so it's, we've said it's cross-platform, can be compared to JavaScript, statically, it's also open source. Let's have our last advantage, that Kotlin is tool friendly. Okay, so tool friendly. Okay, and of course this actually makes a lot of sense, given that the company that has created Kotlin is one of the best, one of the most renowned companies for creating IDEs. Okay, so it's actually developed by Jetbrains. Kotlin itself is developed by Jetbrains, a company known for creating development tools for professional programmers. So Kotlin also is tool friendly. Okay, and in fact we're going to be using it with the IntelliJ IDEA IDE. So that is it. Of course it's also safe, it's a safe language. Okay, the advantages is the safety that you get, in that it's actually aimed at removing some of the dangers of the null references from code. Okay, so in fact this is such a big advantage and a quite an improvement of Java that we have to put it down. So Kotlin is safe. Okay, now it of course removes the dangers, okay, or the risks of null references from code. Okay, if you've worked with Java, and we have done a lot of work in Java here at Programmers TV, you may have realized that majority of the time you keep on getting null pointer exceptions. Okay, so Kotlin inherently allows you to of course avoid those headaches by removing the dangers of getting those null references. Okay, so the fact we've also said that it's also statically typed, also this allows us to catch more errors. Okay, so we can also, hence we can catch more errors in Kotlin. So yeah, those are some of the advantages, guys, that we need, okay, to know while before we jump to Kotlin. Okay, so we're going to talk a lot about it. So in fact, what are some of the companies that are using Kotlin? Okay, so let's come right here, list some of them. There's a lot of companies that are using Kotlin. So major companies already using Kotlin. So okay, the first company we have, the Pinterest. We also have the Uber is also making use of Kotlin. Then we have the Netflix. Okay, so you can see these are top tier companies right here. Okay, so we have the Trello. Okay, and then we also have the Coda. So these are some of the companies that are already making use of Kotlin. Okay, so yeah, that is it. right there in Kotlin. So Kotlin is actually quite rising, okay. And in fact, at a recent Google I/O that was held on, of course, May 2017 last year, the Android team announced, of course, Kotlin as an official language for Android, okay. So yeah, you just can just know that one. So you can actually replace your Java code with Kotlin seamlessly, okay. They are 100% interoperable. So of course, yeah, so guys, I think that's enough of an introduction to Kotlin, okay. In the next class, we're going to see how, of course, we can actually use Kotlin in IntelliJ IDEA, how, of course, we can use it and create our project, create our first Hello World application, okay. For now, I think that's it. Go ahead, subscribe to our channel, Programmers TV, and also, we have created another new channel, Computer Science TV, where we'll be covering computer science concepts, okay. So those both are our channels, but our main channel is Program Users TV. We also have our website camposha.info, so go visit them, and also take care. I'll catch you in the next class.